All right, it looks like looks like we're live. Okay. Hi guys. So in my I was browsing around the internet and saw a little news blurb about NetherRealm Studios, the makers of Mortal Kombat, and something saying that they were considering doing a fighting game that was solely based on slasher films. Now they've put, you know, characters in the last couple Mortal Kombat games, Freddy Krueger, Jason, you know, the Xenomorph from Alien, Predator, stuff like that. And in my while reading that, I was just curious, and I was just looking through some other like slasher related things, and I found found Terrordrome. Now Terrordrome, it was created, let me pull this up real quick. So it was created by some I don't know if it was a single person or a group of guys, but they used 2D Fighter Maker 2002 as a fighting game engine where you can create your own fighters, and they did 3D rendering and in a 2D art style. So I'm going to read you their little about section on their website. Terrordrome, Rise of the Boogeyman, is a free fan-made game, a tribute to the most popular horror movie icons of the 70s, 80s, to 90s. And for the first time, all your favorite horror characters are bound together in a unique fighting game. Decide who's the most evil and badass boogeyman in fearsome battles. Terrordrome is a dream come true for any fan of the horror genre and video games. That's me. This game makes use of 3D models that faithfully replicate the iconic characters and integrate them as 2D art style. Each of their fighting styles stay true to their nature and abilities as seen in the movies. They are put in motion with top-notch keyframed 3D animation. The sounds are directly grabbed from the movies and add to the faithfulness of each character. Every fighter has its own stage that comes directly from a particular scene in their movie. They were also done in 3D and then rendered into a 2D background. And the game is powered by 2D Fighter Maker 2002, a 2D fighting game engine, much like Mugen. Which Mugen is a pretty cool fighting engine, which people have made crazy fighting games with. Like, you know, Marvel vs. Capcom. Well, they've done fighting games where they just took pop culture figures from all over the place and had them fighting, and it's pretty cool. I would suggest searching some footage from people making games with Mugen. And the game started as a hobby and took around 9 years to be completed, from the prototype stage to the final product. Now this has been out for a while, and I feel like I've heard about this before, but I never really had a PC that I was able to play games with, or there was some reason or another that I just never got around to it. But the thing about me is that I am a huge horror fan, and slashers in particular, I adore. I've grown up with them. I've been watching slasher movies since I was 3 or 4 years old, and this is gonna be cool. I played a little bit just to test it out, and it's, I don't know, it's something else. Like, if NetherRealm could pull off what these guys have done, in the sense that, like, in just how true they stayed to the films that they're pulling from, I can't even imagine what we're gonna see. I'll give a couple shoutouts real quick. Hi, Ms. Virgo, True Canadian, SSJ, Key Gaming, Gavin Bishop, Travis Riley. Hi, everybody. Thank you for watching. Now, we should probably get to the game, huh? So, we got story mode, versus mode, and training. Now, versus mode, you would need two people with. I don't have two people, so I believe there is some kind of multiplayer or, online network play. I don't know how to get that. I don't even know if their network is still running, because this, like I said, is an older game. There was talk about a second game, but, I don't know. So, we're gonna go straight to story mode. Now, quick note, if I have to change characters, there's no real, like, at least that I found, there's no way to go back to the menu. I saw that there was some kind of button combination that you can get back to the menu, but I might have to actually close out the window and restart it. So in case the screen goes black or anything, don't be alarmed. It's just me wanting to change characters, just to kind of get a better feel of the game. Now we're going to go to story mode.
Choose your killer.
Oh. Oh. Okay. So we got Leatherface from Texas Chainsaw Massacre. Now, this looks to be the Leather... It looks more like Leatherface from the 2002 remake or 2003 remake. So we got, of course, Ashley Williams from Evil Dead and Evil Dead 2 and Army of Darkness. This is the Evil Dead 2 representation towards the end of the film or the beginning of Army of Darkness. Chucky from Child's Play. Ghostface from Scream. Maniac Cop, which is the fact that they threw Maniac Cop in there is so awesome. We got two Jasons in this. We got this is Undead Jason from this looks to be the more like the Takes Manhattan or Jason X, like the beginning of Jason X. Jason, we got one of my favorites, Pinhead from Hellraiser, who I have my Pinhead Funko Pop sitting right over there. I'm not gonna get up and grab it. Pumpkinhead. It's fucking Pumpkinhead. This is ridiculous. Herbert West from Re-animator. Which, by the way, if you guys haven't, if you're into horror at all and you haven't seen these movies, do yourselves a favor. Every one of these movies is worth a watch. We got Candyman, Tony Todd right there. The Tall Man, Angus Scrimm. There's the original hockey mask Jason from Friday the 13th 3. Michael Myers, of course, from Halloween. And the King, ladies and gentlemen, is Freddy Krueger. All right, so, I don't know. I'm kind of leaning towards Ash on this one, because I feel like I want to be the good guy going up against all the bad guys. Although, I mean, Herbert West, I wouldn't really consider him a bad guy so much as just fucked up, but I don't know. What do you guys say? Now, let me see in the chat. Who do you guys think I should go with? Oh, this is tough. I kind of want to give the Tall Man a try, too. Hey, Chris Dotson. Hey, Dean Pike. Hello, Eric R. Glad to see you're alive. Let's see. I got a Freddy. I'm assuming that's Freet. I got Ash, two Ashes. I was leaning towards Ash myself. Hey, Peyton. Pinhead. Ooh. Freet. Gavin really wants Freet. Chucky. Okay. This is tough, guys. I might have to go. I got two for Ash, so I might start with Ash. But we'll make our way through. I wanna give each of them a try. Yeah, let's go with Ash. Now this is my first time, so I'm just gonna do hard or easy mode, just because I wanna get into it. You know, see how it goes. Burger Love. I do like scary movies, but I've just never heard of half. You've never heard of half of those? What? How have you never... I mean, I can understand maybe, like, Pumpkinhead or Maniac Cop, because those were smaller movies, but, like, come on. Come on. Alright. Hi, Xander. Yeah, that's another Ash. We're going with Ash right now. Yeah, absolutely. Yo, Petey. Sorry, Team Geo. OJ Simpson, I don't have that DLC yet. Ooh. You're not very hard to find, Mr. Williams. In fact, I came to warn you. You're in great danger. Cenobites are after you, and the Necronomicon. Powerful demons. Ash was lucky West could also help him out. What a nice guy. Oh, this is fucking ridiculous. This is so badass. Hey, Dalton. Oh. All right, so... Before I start, we do have a moves list here. I'm using an Xbox 360 controller, and I've kind of figured out what all these are. So I got my punch, my kick, my weak weapon, strong weapon. trauma. Okay, cool. All right. I just tried the menu button, and that wasn't working for me before, so let's go back into this. Sorry. Hey, Jack. Hey, Zach. Oh, I already said hi, Zach. All right, we're going to go back into this. All right. So, look at that! Ah! Oh, good lord! This is easy? Yes! Ooh! Yes! Oh, this is fucking amazing! The stages are so badass. The re-animator stage, this is great. Let me see. I should have looked up. They apparently, I don't know if they're finishing moves, but they have that green bar underneath their health, which acts as I think it's called the Unleash Fury or something. Oh, you sack of shit! Cheap. Okay. Okay. It's a little clunky, but it's not bad. I mean, considering this was made with a generic fight game maker. Come on, where? Oh, do I not have any more of the? Oh no. Oh my god. Well, that went great. Hey Dalton, hey Christian Young.
Fight.
Yes! His fucking gas canister thing is killing me.
Groovy.
Oh shit, the Necronomicon. Oh! Well, that didn't help. Undead help. Nice. Hit him in the face with a shovel. Hey, Alex Galvez. Oh, man. Dude, the animation in this is fucking amazing. I mean, the 3D rendered characters and everything look great. Now my biggest downfall in fighting games is that I don't block ever, and there is a block function. See? Ooh. And I don't know. It's like when I'm racing in GTA. I don't break ever. I just kind of like to go as hard as I can and see how it plays out. If I fail, I fail. Whatever. Ooh! Oh shit. Oh man. When are we gonna play Forest? I think we're gonna go tomorrow night. It'll probably be the last one for a while until they get some really substantial updates. There was just an update, but nothing big. More just like fixes to the game, some fixes to textures and stuff. And we've gone pretty far with the Forest in terms of what they have to offer right now. So, tall man! Here's another one, guys. If you've ever seen Phantasm, it's a trippy fucking movie. And little fun fact, I'm Ash fighting the tall man. Phantasm was directed by Don Coscarelli, who also directed Bubba Hotep, which was a Bruce Campbell-featured film where he played Elvis Presley, an aged Elvis Presley who faked his own death and had to fight a zombie mummy in a senior community, an assisted living facility.
Chaos.
Yeah. Pretty badass. Oh, bye, Chris. Oh, no! Oh, no, the dwarfs! Ah! Fucking phantasm ball, man. Tall man's got some flippin' reach. Boomstick. All right. There it is, Phantasm. What do we fight next? Ooh, Candyman. I like that the fight announcement font, the little fight one or round one thing is the Friday the 13th text. Ah. Oh shit! Okay, I gotta get. Oh, he's got his bees. Take him! Oh, oh, my mini ashes failed. I mean, I'm kind of getting my ass kicked. I'm not really, no flawless victories yet, but I feel that's very true to Ash. I feel I'm doing him proud. The nerdgasm is real right now. Very true, Peyton. Part two, that's awesome. The fact that they're calling it part one and part two. Oh! I don't remember that from the movie. Good lord! Okay, come on. What the hell just happened? Oh, you sack of shit! Alright, yeah, I gotta start blocking. How about that? I don't know what the point of the taunt is. It doesn't really seem to do anything. Oh! Suck on the boomstick! This fucking Superman thing is wrecking me. What the? Oh, he used his unleash thing. Oh god, I gotta figure that thing out.
In death, you will become legend.
Well, that happened.
Fight.
Okay. Ah. You know, I might just go through this whole. I just realized, if I start story mode, it might be all the same order that I'm fighting the monsters or the slashers. And I mean, I could do that, but I mean, as far as stopping the game and starting with a new character, but I kind of don't want to just fight the same people over. Sack of shit. There. Oh no, so close. Are you kidding me?
In death you will become legends.
Man, reanimate. Yes.
I came for it.
Oh, I like that it gave the location and time. Illinois, 3:43 a.m. or something. Oh, fuck you, Candyman. Hey, Boosis! Oh, Candyman is amazing, Peyton. I agree. Now, Candyman, I can't remember. Was that a Clive Barker story or production? I can't remember. Clive Barker is one of my favorite horror writers or creators of all time. He's the creator of Pinhead, or Hell Knight, as he's known in the books. Who, funny enough, Hell Knight was never actually supposed to be a big part of the story. He was just, you know, he's one of the Cenobites, but the imagery that Clive created for him in the movie, it was so iconic that he became known as Pinhead and became the center of that franchise. And you can't, they haven't had a Hellraiser movie since without Pinhead. Fight. Come on, you son of a bitch. Should probably pay attention now, huh? I got it. Oh no! Wake up, Ash! What the hell? Come on! Fucking fight him! Okay. Candyman, that was a fucking block. How about that? Oh, that was terrible. Huh. Oh, man. Did you miss anything, Gavin? Nope, just killing folks. All right, let's go. Let's try somebody else. Actually, real quick, you know what? I'm gonna look up the moves. Unleash. Okay. So, all right. So I've got the moves list in front of me. Who should I do? 872 subs. Yeah, I'm 128 away from 1,000. Thank you guys. Thank you so much, and thanks for coming out right now. You know, it's an early stream. I think we're gonna go on tonight with Snake Fist. So I wanted to get this in there. Plus, like, this was one that I had to do, and I understand this is absolutely not a game for everybody. You know, it's a cheesy fighting game. Made by an indie developer using a fighting game maker, essentially. And it's horror themed, so it's not for everybody, but you know, for you guys sticking around, thank you. Dean Pike, play as Chucky. You know what, Gavin's been screaming Freet and Freddy and Freedy. You know what, how about we'll do some Freddy action, and then we'll go on to maybe Chucky. Chad downloaded GoldenEye Source last night besides there. Chad downloaded GoldenEye Source last night besides there's being no one to play with. It was pretty awesome. Okay. You play it, Boosis. You played GoldenEye. Yeah, we got it, and we're trying to work on that. We haven't tested it with the network yet, so.
Choose your difficulty.
Hey, Joseph. Alright, so we're gonna go Freddy and. Well, I'm assuming the story would be different. Freddy wasn't easily scared, but this time, he was in trouble. Cenobites in the dream world? Probably looking for him. He cheated death once and escaped their hell with the help of dreams demons. But he knew they would couldn't read that, whatever. When I was about 7 years old, my father let me watch all Halloweens, all Chucky movies, all Friday the 13th, all Evil Dead and Army of Darkness, and I've watched all Nightmare on Elm Street. Yeah, same here. I've been watching them since I was 3 or 4, and, fighting Leatherface! Oh, no! Ooh, Freddy's quick. Let's see, what do we got? Oh, okay, so you know what? I think... pardon me. I think... Firewall and Freddy Worms. Yeah, so Firewall and Freddy Worm. The bottom two... the bottom three. The combo string is your big combo. And the two above that are going to be the unleashed attacks, which is not a finisher, but it's just a more impressive attack. And Freddy Worm, I'm assuming, is gonna be different. Let's see how that works. All right, so we got teleport, ground claw. I mean, if you've ever played a fighting game, you kind of most moves are essentially the same. They've got the same layout: down to forward punch, back down forward kick, shit like that. So it's not too hard to get a hold of this. Now grabbing down to forward and P. That's one that's been giving me trouble. It doesn't really respond well, and doesn't work all the time. Aye! Oh! Oh! Oh, yeah! Holy shit! There we go. Oh! Dude, I fucked him up. Like Freddy. Now, Freddy always was my favorite slasher. What I would love to see, if they actually got to do their second one, I would love them to throw in, like, Victor Crowley from Hatchet or Leslie Vernon from Behind the Mask. That would be fucking bonkers. Oh. Because it's not like there's been a lot of iconic slashers introduced over the past 15, 20 years. Probably the most notable would be Ghostface, but... Victor Crowley and, oh, jeez. Oh, Bear Trap. What? Ah, got me. Oh, I did the worm. Oh. Holy shit. And I died. Oh, come on. Yes. Oh, man. Yeah, I can't think of any other, notable slashers, iconic slashers. Other than Victor Crowley, Sam from Trick or Treat would be awesome. Samael, the spirit of Halloween. Fucking Candyman, you're not taking me this time. I got speed on my side now. Yes, dude, fucking Freddy is vicious. Wow. Told you Freddy is the best. It's not about being the best, though. It's, you gotta go with who you love, and I love Ash. Not to mention, like I said, it was very true to fashion, Ash getting his ass handed to him. Which, by the way, if you guys haven't watched Evil Dead vs. Ash on Stars, so good. So fucking good. It ended with a cliffhanger. Not so much a cliffhanger, but a setup of the next season that was so perfect for the character and the world. It was just like, yeah, that's what would happen to Ash. Ooh, Black Sludge. I don't want to go near that. Ground claw. Oh, is the slime mine? Oh, come on. Rob Zombie does do good. I enjoy his horror movies. But the thing is, like, I wouldn't say he introduced a singular iconic slasher. Like, you had Captain Spaulding and Otis, but I wouldn't really say that they're as iconic. Captain Spaulding probably a little more so, just because of, like, his design, and Otis when he had the skull makeup on in A Thousand Corpses, but I don't think they really had the lasting power of somebody like Freddy Krueger. Like, they weren't game-changing. Now, the reason I would say that Sam from Trick or Treat was, is because it kind of brought back that kind of why don't I have the word? This sort of vignette kind of movie, like Creepshow, like the short stories kind of horror movie. Oh, I wasn't even paying attention. I'm at fucking Camp Crystal Lake. This looks great. I'm fighting old school Jason right now. Pennywise would be fantastic to have in a fighting game like this. Have his finisher be the fucking giant spider of the deadlights. I told you I watch a lot of horror movies. Jack Torrance from The Shining would be pretty cool. Just have him with his axe. Fuck you, Jason. Pitchfork bastard. I'm trying to think of other slashers from the recent Puppet Master. I mean, now, not necessarily like a singular Puppet Master character, but if you had Andre Toulon, the guy that created the puppets, and had the puppets, have him as the Puppet Master, and then have the puppets be like summons almost, like fucking Pokemon. That would be pretty badass. Oh shit. Dude, fucking, this is cool. I'm in the Woodsboro High hallways. God, why do I even remember the names of these locations? Fuck you. Oh! Dean Pike says, it annoys me that this decade no one has come up with a new horror icon monster. Disgraceful. Yeah, it's... There have been a lot less. I mean, if you haven't seen Hatchet or Behind the Mask, The Rise of Leslie Vernon, definitely go do it. It's, I mean, that was, what, 2005, 2006? So it is within the last decade, and those two are absolutely horror icons. You got Kane Hodder playing Victor Crowley from Hatchet, and, I mean, they're not the greatest movies in the world, but they're fun. Behind the Mask, though, Rise of Leslie Vernon, unbelievable. Oh, oh, oh no! Oh shit! Actually, you know who? You know they got Ash in here. You know who else I would love to see in this? Tucker and Dale. Fucking Tucker and Dale. If you guys don't know who Tucker and Dale are, go on Netflix and watch Tucker and Dale versus Evil. Leprechaun, yes. Leprechaun would that'd be amazing. Warwick Davis in this shit. It's funny, Leprechaun was one of my favorite horror movies when it came out. I got to see it in the theater with my dad, and because we were big Warwick Davis fans. Willow is one of my family's favorite movies. And Star Wars, I mean, he's wicked, so. I remember, for the longest time, he had this stupid limerick in the movie that I would always quote, and I think I still remember it. It was, there once was a man from the grass who had balls made from fine brass, but in stormy weather, them balls clanged together and sparks flew out of his ass. There you go. That happened.
Later. Fight.
If you want to get this game, Christian, I see you want to get this game. If you want to get this game, I put the link to the in the description of the website for the game. Worth getting. Absolutely worth getting. This is so fucking fun. Tall man. Dickhead. Ooh, 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 ooh. I'm gonna take him, Freddy. Ooh, you just reminded me, Creepers 3. Yeah, how about the Creeper from, I wasn't the biggest Jeepers Creepers fan, but I feel like I have to rewatch that, because I haven't seen that in forever, and I just remembered not really caring for it. But the Creeper himself is absolutely iconic. Oh, ooh, Wishmaster. The Djinn from Wishmaster would be great. That's my first loss since I started with Freddy. I also wasn't paying much attention. I was thinking of, horror movies. You little bastards. Doing streams by myself or with other people? I like them both. It is tougher. I thought the doing it by myself would be harder. Because I don't. I'm better when I have somebody. Maniac cop. I'm better when I. Really? What the? Okay. I'm better riffing off of people. But I've had a lot of fun. This is my second time streaming on my own with nobody in the playing any games with me. I mean, I did the Rocket League solo stream the other day, which actually had a danger popped in, so that was fun. And then James Jumbao too. But in terms of just me sitting by myself, not talking to anybody else except you guys, I'm liking it more than I thought I would. Especially when I'm doing stuff like this. This is something I love. I like talking about horror movies, and I love talking about horror movies with people that like them too. It's a fun time. The first time I did it, I wasn't nervous about it, but I also wasn't expecting anything from it. I was like, I'll just play a game. It'll probably just be me sitting here like this. But I'm trying to be able to go back and forth between the game and the chat, and I'm enjoying it. I really am enjoying the solo stuff. Plus, when you're streaming with everybody else, especially like yesterday, I was SFE and Team Geo, and somebody was asking why I was so quiet. You've got so many people trying to play that game, and especially with like people who are kind of like not in charge, but the ones who kind of lead the direction of everything. You just have to find your spots with that, whereas doing it this or with just one or two other people, there's more room for you to be able to just, you know, actually say something. I like both, though. I like both. Fucking head, come on. What was that? Ooh! Is that my hellfire? Firewall! Nice. Your dad, Virgo's dad, said boom shake, boom shake, or boom shaka, boom shaka. Ooh! Long Freddy arms. I gotta watch Pumpkinhead again, it's been too long. Just remember it being a sad movie. Maybe Pumpkinhead 2. One of those. One of those, like, depressed me, and I was just like, oh, worm! Dang it! Ah, shit, I wish I had killed him with that. That would have been a good finisher. Is it wrong that I enjoy Chad Solo? You're allowed to enjoy Chad Solo. I think. I don't know. Ooh, that's not a bad idea, Peyton. Red Queen from Umbrella Corporation or Nemesis. I wouldn't really say they're slashers, but that would be interesting. I'm actually kind of surprised that no fighting game has tried to throw in... What is this? Zombies. This is crazy. It's like a fucking Street Fighter bonus round. Break the car. Break the zombies. Oh shit. Oh no, it froze! Oh no! Oh no! I was, oh. Well, you know what? I'll start it with the, there's an intro that you can get, and I wasn't able to do that for streaming purposes, so now I'll start it with the intro. How about that? Damn it! I was doing so good. Once again, we got Leatherface, Ash, Chucky, Ghostface. Is it still loud? It seems loud. Alright. Maniac Cop, we got Jason, Pinhead, Pumpkinhead, Herbert West, Candyman, Tallman, Jason, Michael Myers, and Freddy. We've already done Freddy and Ash. You know what? Somebody mentioned Chucky earlier, and I'm kind of curious. Yeah, this Virgo wants Chucky. We're doing Chucky.
Choose your difficulty.
Is it still too loud, guys? Let me know. Sorry, Gavin. Yeah. No sign of himself in any newspaper was getting on Chucky's nerves. Myers, Cordell, Voorhees, but nothing about the killer doll. Show them all who's the greatest. I wish I could do a Brad Dourif voice, but I can't. Chucky took on the task to make things clear. Alright, so Chucky's whole story is he just wants recognition for his deeds.
Don't hang up
I'm
on me.
Chucky.
I need home.
Fight.
I like that it's... Oh, shit. Got the nail gun.
Bullseye.
I like that it's changing up the... Yeah, it's still really loud. Alright, there we go. Yeah, I like that it's it changes the order that you're fighting based on the character. I mean, it's not like there's really any purpose behind it. I guess it's just to shake things up, but... What do we got? Ooh.
No way. This is
whoa! Like fucking Yoda. What the fuck is the handstand for? Why? Oh, shit. I don't... I mean, sure. That's a thing. He does.
Like you've seen a ghost.
Now, admittedly, it's been a while since I've watched any Child's Play films, but I don't remember handstands being very big in his repertoire. Yes. Fucking voodoo. That's it. Ah. Not as oh, there we go. Not as quick as Freddy, but. We got super nailing. Oh shit.
Wrong answer.
Oh.
Oh.
This is nuts. This is nuts. This is nuts.
KO.
It again.
Okay. Patrick Bateman. Ah. Bateman from Psycho. Wow. Andrew WK is asking, Bundy versus Dahmer, who wins? Bundy. Absolutely Bundy. Bundy, like, Dahmer was kind of like a, just a bit of a loner, and his whole thing was that he wanted to, oddly enough, he wasn't very big into eating people. He got known for it because of how fucked up it was, but he even admitted he wasn't a big fan of the taste. His big thing was that he was trying to remove a part of the brain that controls free will so he can create sex slave zombies, essentially. In the classic sense of the word zombie, not undead, but like under his spell, essentially. Whereas Bundy was a vicious bastard who was also a smooth talker, not to mention the fact that he escaped, I think, 3 maximum security prisons. Oh, yeah, Bundy was pretty hardcore. What? What was that? Pamela. That was his mother! Holy shit! Alright, that was awesome. Come on, fucking Jason.
Bunzo.
Yeah. I'm gonna roll. Keep going, Chucky! Fucking handstand. Oh! He cut my foot! It's okay, my doll. Yes! Nail gun. Nice. Jason has a bow in the movies? Jason has had a bow in the movies. Jason has used all kinds of weapons in the movies. He's used spear guns, pitchforks, machete is the one he's kind of known for, but, yeah, no, he's... What are you doing? Oh, was I pinned down by the arrow? Yeah, it's funny, like, unless you regularly watch slasher movies, a lot of what you know about these figures are kind of what's represented, by... It's their public image. Jason's known for the machete. Freddy's known for the claws. But they've, all of them, for the most part, have used some pretty crazy ways of killing people. Jason's probably used the most. He's probably got the most varied style of kills. I mean, it also helps that he's got the most movies out of anybody. But I mean, everything from, you know, shoving a spear through a wall to kill somebody to grabbing a girl in a sleeping bag and smashing it against a tree. It's, you know, something you do right.
Name's Ash.
Hey, Homer.
Housewares.
Okay. Oh, it's the cabin.
Groovy.
Now, I almost kind of wish that they had gone a little bit further with the background in this one and have the, have, like, the face appear on the front of the house.
Latu, Verada!
Shit.
Groovy.
Shed in the back.
Bullseye.
Oh, come on. Damn right. If you haven't noticed, I'm loving this game.
Let's go.
Ah. You know what? I wasn't really digging Chucky at first, but once he gets into his, he gets into a groove with his combos, and it's pretty brutal. Oh! I like his taunt. No, Jason definitely had the most weapons. Homer's saying he would have thought Chucky would have had the most weapons out of the three. No, Jason, man. Jason's... he's had the most amount of kills, the most movies, so the most opportunity. Oh, zombie level again. Your handstand's not gonna work against these fucking zombies. Come on. Get your shit together. Alright, so apparently this game doesn't like the zombie level. I'm gonna have to look into that. Well, let's start it again. Because why not? Okay, So I don't know if that's on my end or if it's on their end. I'm gonna have to look into that. Alex is saying the funny thing about Jason is that he walks and while his victims are running and he still catches them. So I've got two things to say to that. One, check out the remake of Friday the 13th. It has Jared Padalecki in it. It's not a bad remake, aside from the fact that their best kills are in the first 15 minutes. But he full-on sprints towards people, and it's terrifying. But two, once again, going back to Behind the Mask, Rise of Leslie Vernon.
Choose your killer.
They reference that. I don't want to spoil what the movie is for you. I want to encourage you guys to go check that movie out. Behind the Mask, Rise of Leslie Vernon. It pretty much takes everything you knew or thought you knew about the slasher genre, and just flips it on its head, and dissects it, and it's so good. It's presented as a kind of like a mockumentary, but also a horror film, like pieced together. And everybody in it. There's a little cameo appearance from Robert Englund in there. It's a good one to check out. Jason had once used just a bar of soap to kill someone. I don't remember that one, but I'll take your word for it. I believe it. Hey, Michael Singleton. Let's see. Who should I go with? I kind of want to do Pinhead. Because I did Freddy. Freddy's my favorite slasher, and I wouldn't really consider Pinhead a slasher. But Pinhead's one of my favorite characters from anything ever. Or Hell Knight, as I was saying. Yeah, we're going Pinhead. Let's do Pinhead. I'm afraid to try it on hard because it's not easy. Actually, no. Now that I've got the feel for it, the lead Cenobite Pinhead was brought back to Earth once again. But this time something was wrong. Impossible to know who summoned him. Maybe the summoner didn't come from this world? He would have figured it out anyway. It didn't come from his word. I don't know. Get ready for the next fight. Oh, good. Good find, Eric. Hey, Fire King.
I'm satisfied.
Alright, Pinhead's kind of slow. But he's got his chains, so that's nice, I guess. Oh, right! Okay, I saw an image of this, I want to try it out. his unleash attack. Okay. Cenobite assist. No! I wasted it? Ah, you son of a bitch! No! Alright, Ghostface is fucking irritating.
Darkness is where you find me. Wins.
Ooh, face cam. Yeah, James, figure I'd give it a shot. See how it went. Oh. Yeah, Pinhead's a little slow, but I mean, you know, once again, true to the movies, he's not a quick guy. He doesn't rely on physicality to win.
Darkness is where you find me. Wins.
No tears. It's a waste of good suffering. I am forever.
Hellraiser again. Love those movies.
Fights.
I kind of wish that they had the original Leatherface in this. The kind of cross-dressing look. Or, well, not cross-dressing, but he had the kind of the blend of female faces with the lipstick on it and everything. Ooh. That was weird. What's my taunt?
I am forever.
Oh, okay. Here, come towards me. Oh, damn it. Liking the hairstyle. I mean, thanks. It's not much of a style. I'm not one for style, really. Mine's more out of a necessity. I get hot, I need less hair. I can't imagine the work that went into making this game. This is... Everything has been so good. Like, as far as the actual gameplay goes, they're relying on an engine that it essentially lays down a template for you to use. So they're not creating their own game engine in this. So there's pretty much just them putting their own paint job on it. But the detail that they put in, I would love to do something like this. Not that I ever will. I mean, I would never have the patience for it, but... Or the talent. I'd put that out there. Why is he... I like his... On his knees. Ah! What the hell? I just looked like I was crucified. Whoa! I guess that was Chain Fury.
Colonel, darkness is where you find me.
Bye, WK. Thanks for stopping by, dude.
Fight.
I want to see if they have any, like, developers' diaries on this. To see if they have any of the work that they put in. I don't understand how they did it. This is just getting me excited about NetherRealm talking about doing a slasher game. I really hope they do it. But I hope they would, like, I would really hope that they would put in, like, those bonus stages, like the zombies thing, and do shit where you're, like, stalking through a house or, like, doing stage kills like that. Ah, man. Getting all excited. Yes, I just dropped soda on my mouth. Or on my shirt. I'm a slob.
Your soul belongs to me. Fight.
Ah! Starting off with that fucking taser again, dude. Okay. Oh! Yeah, there comes a point in these fighting games where you just start button mashing and you'll do something that you weren't expecting to do. Like, I don't know, teleport? I just want to do the Cenobite. Help. Come on. Cenobite assist. So that would be down to back. Strong weapon. Alright. Yes. No! No! Oh, God damn it. I wasted it again.
That's where you find me.
Am I going to watch Death House when it comes out? Death House. I can't recall what Death House is. Refresh me. I'm done. I've had enough of Pinhead. I want to try somebody else out. Let me see. Kicks. Kicks. Oh.
How dare
you. Okay. Kick. There we go. Okay. Who haven't we... I think we've seen everybody in play. But who do I want to try? So I've tried Ash, Freddy, Chucky, and Pinhead. Kind of want to see a little bit more Pumpkinhead. Death House. A secret government facility becomes ground zero for the most horrific prison break of the in the history of mankind. Why can't I remember that? I can't think of that. I don't know if I... It's not a bigger movie, is it? James, I am playing... the old Xbox 360 controller. Which was already pre-mapped out and everything, so that's nice. Didn't have to really do anything in that respect. Have we really seen Michael? We only saw Michael briefly. You know what? Let's try some Michael. As always, voices spoke to Michael, evil ones. But today one of them spoke louder, making the others silent. Wow, they're using images from, this looks like Zombies Halloween. Time to go, Mikey, we have a little job to do. Michael was smiling and evil and all that horse shit. Fun little fact about Michael Myers, which anybody, any horror fans out there probably know, but his mask is actually a Captain Kirk mask. Well, the original Michael Myers mask is a Captain Kirk mask they spray painted white. Michael Myers is William Shatner. Oh! Thank you. Oh! Okay, what's his... Ha! That's pretty cool. Just trying to... It's one thing I kept forgetting to do is check out the taunts of everybody. What the fuck was that? You know what? We'll go through... let's check out the taunts.
Choose your killing machine.
So, Ash's taunt was the Necronomicon flying around like a bat. Chucky's was flipping you off. Pinhead's is, I am forever. Let me see. Let's try Leatherface. I did draw your avatar, James. Nah, Michael's theme song is amazing. In fact, somebody I know, I can't remember who it was, posted a video. They went and saw John Carpenter live performing the, I don't know how much he performed, but he performed the Halloween theme live. Which I would fucking lose my shit seeing that. John Carpenter is one of my favorite directors of all time. Oh, that's your taunt? Chainsaw pelvic thrust, okay. It's his. Chainsaw Berserker death dance. Oh, I want to see a death dance. Two leather faces. Not bad. The claw, Freddy's claw, when it goes through the ground, sounds like a velociraptor. Or the velociraptor in the beginning of Jurassic Park 1 in the cage. Oh, no, don't kill me. I got it. Death dance. No. Oh, okay, that's the death dance. All right. All right, bye, James. Probably not going to go too much longer. I'm going to try to quit out of this. There we go.
Choose your killing machine. Choose your difficulty.
Oh, I'm sorry, Miss Virgo. Let's take a nap. You can fall asleep where you're at. You never do that? Oh. Huh. What? Ah! The djinn! Which is cool, because, you know, Scream is Wes Craven. Wishmaster's Wes Craven. Huh? Huh? Kinda cool. There's no doubt in my mind that if they made a second one, they'd throw the djinn in there.
Don't hang up on me.
Fight.
Already? Seriously? Oh, there's the spear gun. You know, I thought the ghost face would be a little quicker. There we go. Oh, shit. Oh, come on. He does the head crunch. All right. Plan on doing some GTA? Not today. We got something else planned for today with Snake Fist. But, I mean, at the very least, Sunday will be a GTA stream. And there is a new adversary mode we want to try out. Called Power Play. Which looks pretty cool. It introduces powers into, I guess, regular adversary modes. I don't know. I think I might call it here, guys. I mean, we've kind of seen what this game is all about. And this was only intended... I only intended to go a little bit for this one anyway. Oh, don't worry, Peyton. I'll look up Death House. I'll absolutely look that up because that sounds interesting. But yeah, I think, yeah, SFE is going to be streaming tonight. We're still not... we're still figuring everything out. So I guess keep an eye out for... Twitter and no, not DayZ. Although Russell did give me a copy of DayZ as an early birthday present. 6 months early, but it's nice of him. And no, we got something else planned that looks like it's going to be pretty cool. So definitely keep an eye out. We'll tweet out everything once we get once we figure it out. And yeah, I think I'll call it right now. I mean, like I said, we saw what this game is about. I didn't play through every character, but we got to see every character in motion, in play, and it was badass. I really hope that this team does a second one. I would absolutely be on board with that. So check out the link in the description if you guys want to try this out. It's a lot of fun. And, like, comment, subscribe, all that fun stuff. We're almost at 1,000, or I'm almost at 1,000. So thank you so much, guys, for that. It's been crazy how quick this has been going. So I will see you guys next time, or possibly later tonight. Most likely later tonight. And, yeah. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Bye, Homer. Bye, James. Bye, Ms. Virgo. Fire King. Michael Singleton. Peyton. Joseph Brewer, Alex Rojas, Eric R, thanks for coming in by, guys. Well, we did see Pumpkinhead here. I'll pull up Pumpkinhead real quick just so you can see him. And I'll end it on that. But, thank you so much for watching, guys. And, yeah, we'll go out on Pumpkinhead.
Once again, the demon of revenge had been summoned. With a new prey to hunt down. But chasing another demon was rather unusual. Never mind. Nothing would stop Pumpkinhead in his task.
Because he's born of vengeance, you see. It's his sole purpose.
Pumpkinhead.
Pumpkinhead! Candyman! That's Pumpkinhead. Sorry. All right. Thanks for hanging out, guys. And I'll see you later. Thank you to the mods for being around. You guys are fucking badass. Bye, everybody.